Are you live streaming?
Can I ask that you turn that off, please?
Nope.
Okay. Oh, I asked nicely.
Okay. I was trying to be nice when I said no.
Okay.
Thank you. I got here when things had already started, but it does look that way. There's I'm pretty sure there's a dead man on the other side of the police car. They covered him with a yellow sheet and the paramedics left. The only thing I can't say for certain is whether he was hit by the train. The train did stop, and the man did die, so that's probably the most likely explanation. I don't quite understand why they're going for so much tape when it's railroad right away anyway, and no one has the authority, no one has the right to go there. But
I want to know if that's my friend, because he lives right here.
All I could see was that he, and I don't know how much I should reveal prior to them notifying the next of kin or whatever, but it was a man with short hair,
really, really short.
It looked kind of more like your length, but maybe a little shorter. Kind of a almost gray, but darker than that.
Oh, he was an older man.
I think so.
Okay.
I think so. Yeah, not probably a kid. Not anybody in their 20s, 30s, 40s even. Yep. I did not.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. I think there's a strong misconception around the difference between the concept of we're not releasing information pending notification of next of kin and we're keeping everything secret pending notification of the next of kin. I think people have slipped toward that second thing when really the first thing is considerate and within scope, and the second thing is kind of ridiculous. You're not going to keep everything secret. And there's no reason to. I mean, look how, here's one guy just walked by and got his fears alleviated that it was his friend, potentially, right? So he's now not walking around thinking, oh, maybe my friend died today. Also, if I was live streaming, people would know to take an alternate route. So I can see two cars on the other side, one looks like a Tucson Parks police. They have those light blue cars. They go around the park asking people for ID and what they're doing and where they're coming from and fun stuff like that. And the other one's a black and white. So I assume they're over there letting people know that they're not going to get through here anytime soon. And I assume we're waiting for the county coroner, medical examiner. And I am planted right here in the strip of shade offered by this thankfully metal telephone pole. And you know, it's cool on this side despite being metal, and it's not wood full of creosote covered splinters, so I can actually lean against it and not be breathing in creosote. There is a tricked out black vehicle there, bumper guard, tinted windows all around. And a guy with a short sleeve shirt and some kind of insignia. So I'm thinking this might be our guy. Or a detective. He's not carrying a bag or anything. So he's no detective. I've seen Sherlock Holmes. Guy carries a bag. It's got a magnifying glass in it. Maybe some fingerprint powder. So he's just some gawker. These cowards hiding behind the trees. That's sarcasm. I can move like 2 feet. But already the shade is narrower here. So I can't see much of what they're doing. Certainly can't hear them. I'm not sure what this property is. It's completely unmarked. So I don't know if this entire stretch between the road and the tracks is railroad right of way. It's not marked, so I feel like I could approach more closely, but there's no shade there. And I've already gotten too much sun today. And when you know you've gotten too much sun, you've definitely gotten too much sun. I think I'll start carrying my telephoto lens around. I just got a much, much, much lighter laptop yesterday, day before. So I can afford to add some grams. I'll carry the telephoto lens. I'm not sure about if that changes some things about filming, but as far as I know, it doesn't. You know, if you can stand in a public place, you probably can stand somewhere and look with binoculars or something like that, right? Is there any law against magnifying your vision? I mean, wouldn't that have to apply to corrective lenses too? What's that? I'm pretty sure it's a man.
Huh?
I'm pretty sure it's a man.
Oh man, that's terrible.
Yeah. Cut for file length. Yeah. Is that a bike, you say? There was a man. You're welcome. Yeah, I think they're just waiting for the coroner now. Yeah, they stopped, the EMS came, and then they stopped after a few minutes and left. Looks like it. I got here, he was already on the ground, so I didn't see anything happen, but he was right next to the train, so that's probably what happened.
They're the park CFOs, right? Did they take it off on that side or not?